Building up soil organic carbon on farm is a slow process, can be expensive, and the benefits are hard to quantify. But researchers and grower groups in Western Australia say it has the potential to boost crop yields, grain quality, and the health of sandy soils. DAFWA Development Officer Liam Ryan explains the soil carbon challenge facing growers.
Quite tricky trying to build soil carbon levels in WA, primarily because we operate in quite marginal systems. So soil type and climate are typically the main restrictions on what soil carbon levels we can attain. Then when you couple that with the fact that our net primary productivity, basically how much biomass we grow, isn't that great, and you're in warm climate with sandy soils, there's typically not a whole lot of opportunity to store carbon for the most area of WA.
Long-term GRDC and federal government-funded soil biology trials in WA are led by DAFWA research officer Dr. Francis Hoyle. These are investigating changes in soil organic carbon.
So now that the Leader Group long-term soil biology trial has been running for 13 years, there's a lot of great data to pull out of that, and some of the key outcomes we're interested in is the increase in soil organic carbon. So there's been about an 8 tonnes increase in carbon stocks through the 0 to 30 centimetre layer through the application of 80 tonnes of chaff. There's also been a lot of other positive flow-on benefits, so nutrition in particular, we're seeing about an extra 20 kilograms of nitrogen cycled through that organic matter pool just through the addition of organic matter, and also massive increases in potassium and then phosphorus as well. And cation exchange capacity is increased by about 48%, water holding capacity by 6%. So it really affirms all the benefits from increasing soil organic carbon. The challenge for us now is to move from what's probably an unrealistic scenario, the application of 80 tonnes of chaff. So how can we try and increase carbon stocks to those sort of levels through practices that might be ordinary within a farming systems context?
On-farm application of the findings is being investigated by local grower groups, looking at the benefits and pitfalls of a range of strategies to boost soil carbon levels.
At the moment going forward, it's looking at things like soil amelioration, which is quite a hot topic, understanding if we do go through and mobile plough soil profile or spade it, and we have a redistribution of carbon stocks at depth, is that then going to act as a bit of a buffer to help us out late in the season where you have that band per se of cation exchange capacity, nutrient and water retention? So even though we have that loss in carbon, that top 10 centimetres when we do go through and ameliorate through some form of ploughing or significant ploughing, hopefully we can then build up that carbon stock and hopefully through time have a greater soil organic carbon level than we did previously.
Bunteen grower and Leiby Group member Stuart McAlpine has been working for many years to increase his own soil carbon levels.
What excites me most about building a healthy soil that is healthy, you know, chemically, physically and biologically, and building carbon is trying to work out how efficient we can get with our inputs. Because if we can lower our inputs considerably, and I've done this myself on the farm, you know, with what I've been doing with soil biology and soil health, then we reduce our risk quite considerably. And I believe that we can still farm in these dry areas if we can get our input costs right down.
Stuart has been using a range of strategies to improve soil health and nutrient use efficiencies.
Trying to move as much to a controlled traffic system, you know, to maintain that compaction levels. Close attention to pH and incorporation of lime ameliorants. As your soil has the ability to function at a higher level and be more efficient, once you start dropping your fertiliser rates, then some of that biological activity has to kick into gear and start working. And then through the photosynthesis process, the plants were pumping carbon into the soil to feed the biology to help find that nutrition and lift that efficiency in the soil. So the whole soil starts going to another level again. So it's just a continual fine tuning of that system.
Stuart says although the long-term soil biology trial at the Leiby Group site is using uneconomic levels of organic matter, it is providing an indication of the potential benefits to growers when soil carbon levels are elevated.
We're seeing some quite significant differences in yields on particular seasons and a lot more nutrient holding capacity. You know, today, you know, digging up the plants, there were a lot better root structures, pH was better at depth because of that soil structure as well.